to one and all. We, the learners of grade 5 and grade 6, welcome you to the second virtual assembly of SVM for the academic year 2021. I am Kirti Samant from grade 6. On this lovely morning of today, we will be presenting the assembly based on the theme World Day for International Justice. I request everyone to keep yourselves on mute for the smooth functioning of the assembly. Through this auspicious morning ritual of assembly, we wish to convey the importance of justice. World Day for International Justice is celebrated throughout the world on 17th July to recognize the system of international criminal justice. Every year, people around the world use this day to host events which promote justice and especially support the International Criminal Court. It is said that start each day with a positive thought and a grateful heart. So let us hear a positive and inspiring thought from Neva Shah and start the assembly.
Good morning, everybody. Today's thought for International Justice Day is: behind the concept of justice lies the notion of balance that people get what is right, fair, and appropriate. Thank you.
Thank you, Neva, for the wonderful thought. It is very important for everyone to stay updated with current affairs and know the latest news. So here we have Chinmay and Mrunmay, who will share with us some important news headlines.
Good morning, one and all. Today's news is brought by Chinmay and Mrunmay. National news. Forest staff face challenges in saving wild animals from poacher during floods in Kaziranga National Park. The second is Delhi Sikh body starts pre-ambulance service for COVID-19 patients.
Now, international news. First, U.S. reverses decision to cancel visas of students if classes moved online. Second, Ebola is spreading in Western Congo with 48 confirmed cases.
Thank you, Chinmay and Mrunmay, for the insightful news. Speaking about justice and the increasing crime rates everywhere, it is very important for every human being to know self-defense techniques in order to protect oneself. My friends, Dhananjay, Aditya, and Yadniki will now present before you some self-defense illustrations.
Hello friends, today we are going to learn self-defense. First move. First safety hack move which we are trying to showcase it is about getting rescued from the unknown person who tries to grab you unwantedly from behind. Presenting Yadniki and Dhananjay.
1, 2, 3, 4. Second move. Second and safety hack move is about how you will defeat the bad person with shouting and asking for help, and how you will escape from his grip. Presenting Aditya and Dhananjay.
Third safety hack give you an idea how you will hit on the sensitivity part of the body, that is eyes, nose, mouth, throat or bone area, and run.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Thank you everyone for learning safety hacks.
That was really fantastic. Thank you, Dhananjay, Aditya, and Yadniki. I think in today's times, we really need to learn this. I remember having studied that judiciary is an organ of the government which ensures justice. The Supreme Court, the High Court, and the subordinate courts work for the same. We now have Sunidhi Kane, who will tell us about the history of the district court in Ratnagiri.
Hello everyone, this is Sunidhi Kane. 17 July is celebrated as World Day for International Justice. July 17th is the day of the adoption of the treaty that created the International Criminal Court. On this occasion, I would like to mention that our district, Ratnagiri, has a robust history in this field. The district court, Ratnagiri, was established in the year 1867 during British era. The court building has been renovated. However, the area still has an old world charm around it. The district court is situated near the Arabian Sea. The British government had established this district court as Konkan was a very difficult area to travel. Many British-style buildings were constructed in Ratnagiri, including district court and civil hospital. The court recently celebrated 150 years. The court had held many functions and events to mark this anniversary. Thank you.
Thank you, Sunidhi, for the valuable information. It is said that justice postponed is development stopped. Justice should be granted at the right time, otherwise it can turn to be unjust. Highlighting the importance of justice, we have Karthik and Rhea.
I am Karthik.
And I am Rhea. Today, we are going to perform an act on justice delayed is justice denied.
Miss Public Prosecutor, today I will give the verdict on Mrs. Savitri Devi versus Mr. Kantilal case. Please tell them to be present here by 12 noon.
My Lord, my client Miss Savitri Devi is unfortunately unwell and is hospitalized, so she cannot come.
Whatever may it be, now present the evidences or I will give the next date for the hearing.
My Lord, it is so ironical that in a large democracy like India, where every citizen is equal before law, justice is a rare commodity. My client, Miss Savitri Devi, is a widow and has no children or anyone to take care of her. She had filed a case when she was 52 and now she is seeking justice past 25 years, my Lord, past 25 years. The only property she has was her house that Mr. Kantilal has taken falsely by creating fake property papers and getting them signed in the pretext of society welfare. She had immense faith in the judiciary. Alas, this faith has taken away her every penny of savings, my Lord, every penny of savings. Now, I have gathered this final evidence. The original property papers and the statements from the revenue and tehsildar's office proving no transfer of property in any means. Please admit it.
After acknowledging the evidences provided by the same and delving into the arguments by the public prosecutor, this court hereby declares Mr. Kantilal guilty and confers the disputed property to Mrs. Savitri Devi.
Wait, my Lord.
Please proceed.
I honor your judgment and finding the victory of truth. But Miss Savitri Devi has just passed away.
What?
Yes, my lord. She has just breathed her last. And now the judgment cannot bring her back, nor it can redress her grievances. I assert that justice delayed is justice denied.
Thank you.
Thank you, Karthik and Rhea. This was surely an eye-opener for many. When life gives us difficult situations, we many times lack motivation and give up. Motivation is very important in our lives. Now we have a unique performance on the poem Tum Mujhko Kab Tak Rokoge, which will be performed by Pari, Priya, and I request everyone to for a better view.
इस जन्म जितने जुल्म नहीं उतने सहने की ताकत है। इस जन्म जितने जुल्म नहीं उतने सहने की ताकत है। कानों के भी शोर में रहकर सच कहने की आदत है। मैं सागर से भी कह रहा हूं, मैं सागर से भी कह रहा हूं, तुम कितने कंकर फेंकोगे। चुन चुन कर आगे बढ़ूंगा मैं, तुम मुझको कब तक रोकोगे, तुम मुझको कब तक रोकोगे।
That was really full of motivation and spirit. Thank you everyone for the amazing performance. To test our general knowledge about justice, we have Aditya Shanbag, who has a quiz for all of us. All the best. Over to you, Aditya.
Hello and good morning, one and all. Welcome to our own SBA. Sab banenge aware. I am Aditya Shanbag, your quiz master of the day. I will ask you some questions. If you know the answer, simply raise your hand and Shruti ma'am will choose the person who will answer. All are requested to keep your mics on mute and your videos on. Superb, let's begin. The first question, when was the Constitution of India adopted? A. November 26, 1949. B. November 26, 1948. C. November 26, 1950. D. November 26, 1951. Who can answer this?
Karthik.
Yes, Karthik.
It is D, November 26, 1951.
No, that's a wrong answer. The correct answer is A, November 26, 1949. We will go to the next question. The Indian Constitution is the dash Constitution. A, smallest written. B, different. C, longest oral. D, longest written. Who can answer? Kipti.
D, longest written.
Yes, this is the correct answer. Good job. The next question, International Men's Day is celebrated every year on A, 19th November, B, 8th March, C, 2nd October, D, it is not celebrated. We'll answer.
Yes, Sonal ma'am, we can see your hand. Please unmute and answer.
Okay, Sonal ma'am.
First option.
A, November 20. 19th November. Yes, this is the right answer. Good job, ma'am. The third last question. Who was the pointer of the movement for social justice in India? A, Mahatma Gandhi. B, Jawaharlal Nehru. C, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. D, Nelson Mandela. Who will answer?
Yes, Kajal ma'am.
I'm just taking a wild guess.
Okay.
Is it B.R. Ambedkar?
No, ma'am. The correct
answer. What's the right answer?
The correct answer is Mahatma Gandhi.
Okay.
Thank you, ma'am. The second last question. In India, the legal age for a boy to get married is about 8, 12 years. B, 15 years. C, 18 years. D, 22 years. You can answer this.
The teachers are also requested to participate in this.
Yes.
It's so interesting.
Kajal ma'am is so excited.
So you say now.
So indeed.
Who can answer?
Sunidhi.
22 years. D.
Yes, this is the correct answer. The last question of the day. Which of the following is a crime? A, theft. B, murder. C, skin scanning. D, all of above. Who can answer?
All of above.
Who is answering?
Yes, Neema ma'am. She's all excited. Go, Neema ma'am.
It's all of above.
Name the answer.
It's all of above.
Yes, this is the correct answer, Neema ma'am. Good job. Thank you for the brilliant answer. And that was the SBA for the day. Hope that you have become aware now. Thank you for your kind cooperation, shining of Aditya Shanbha.
That was brainstorming indeed. Thank you, Aditya. To make this morning melodious, we present to you today a song called Imagine by John Lennon. The lyrics makes one look the world through a different perspective. A world that has no discrimination, violence, and greed, but has peace and brotherhood. This will be performed by Pal, Mohit, Swara, Devesh, Mahir, Meet, Shagun, Jagundeja, and Jose.
Imagine there's no heaven. Easy if you try.
No help below us, above us only sky.
Imagine all the people living for today.
Imagine there's no countries, it isn't hard to do.
Nothing to kill or die for, and religion too.
Imagine all the people living in peace.
You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us, and the world will be one.
Imagine no opposition, I wonder if you can. No need of greed or hunger, a brotherhood of man. Imagine all the people sharing all the world. Yoo-hoo!
You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us, and the world will be one.
Wow, just imagine if we could really rebuild this world as described in this song, won't that be true justice? Thank you everyone for this amazing performance. Let's give a silent virtual claps for them. To end our today's assembly and uplift our spirits, we will now have the pledge. I request everyone to place your right hand on your heart. I seek to be fair and just in all my actions. I promise to take a stand against all the wrongdoings and stand by right. I promise to speak up with all my honesty and integrity. I pledge to abide by the rules and walk the path of truth, for it will be the best, not just for me, but for the entire human race. Let us now stand in attention for the national anthem. Over to you, Jared, sir.
सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्कल बंगला विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चैठ तरंगा तब शुभ नामे जागे तब शुभ आशीष मागे गाए तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय जय जय
Coming to the end of today's assembly, I would like to say a thought by Benjamin Disraeli. Justice is truth in action. Lastly, I would like to thank our principal, Monica ma'am, and academic head, Kajal ma'am, for providing us such a great opportunity of presenting virtual assembly during these times when we cannot meet in the physical world. I would also like to thank all the parents for the valuable support. I thank our teachers, Jared sir, Sonal ma'am, Snehal ma'am, Shruti ma'am, and Neema ma'am for making this prepare thoroughly and helping us present this assembly. I would like to thank all the participants for their brilliant coordination despite the assembly being virtual. You all were fantastic. Thank you.
Truly said, Kirti, they were really fantastic, overwhelmed with the performance. Excellent performance, guys. A big, big applause. Thank you so much. And thank you, Principal Ma'am, for this great opportunity of this innovative assembly. Thank you so much, Kajal Ma'am and Principal Ma'am. Thank you for that.
Okay. If I don't say something, you know, I'll keep, I'll just like to speak for a minute or so.
Yes.
To the entire grade 5 and 6, and I am just, you know, not able to come back that it is a reality, you know, that such a fantastic assembly can be planned online. I mean, this is just beyond imagination. Second thing, what was that which was missing, which we do in the physical assembly? I think we started with celebrating International Justice Day, but we did a role play, we did poem recitation, we did self-defense act, we did music. Everything, A to Z elements of an assembly were there incorporated in your virtual assembly. And as Kirti was moderating the entire thing and all of you, I would just like to say one thing, children, that whenever we think about justice, you know, we only think about court and judges and this lawyers and all this kind of scene. But if we are taught to be just from the beginning in the school, you know, why do we need to approach the courts? Because we are not able to resolve conflicts. If we learn to resolve conflicts amongst ourselves as students, as adults, I think that's why it's very important when we do life skills in school. It is not a particular book or a particular curriculum, but it is about being able to learn to differentiate between the right and the wrong from the beginning. Okay, so if we are able to do so, we don't need so many courts. As, Karthik and Rui, both of them presented, justice delayed is justice denied. So what is the use of such justice which has to have 25, 30 years old and the person themselves, you know, are not. I was having goosebumps when you did that enactment, okay? So that is what is more important. And now today, children, you have proven, and the teachers of SVM have proven that we can, you know, convert challenges into opportunities. I think this is the biggest message which you have given today from your online assembly is, of course, we will have challenges in life. We are not able to meet in the physical world is the biggest sad moment for all of us right now, you know, but you have converted that beautifully and you have really worked very, very hard. I thank each and every child present in this assembly and each and every mentor present in this assembly that you have done a humongous job, excellent, marvelous. And once again, I think we should close it with a huge round of virtual applause. Thank you so much and God bless you all.
Thank you, ma'am. And kids, I'm so proud of you. Good job. You make us proud.
Great job.
Super.
Kajal ma'am, are you willing to add some words?
Please, Kajal ma'am.
The entire assembly gave me goosebumps. So for the first time in my life, I think I'm speechless. Otherwise, I talk a lot. But I'm speechless because, yeah, they've got me emotional. Thank you. And they always make us proud. And I keep telling that to the children. Every single day, they are making us proud. I don't think I would have been able to pull off such a platform Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you, ma'am. Yes.
Thank you.
Shruti ma'am, I think we can wind up with this.
Yes, I'll stop the recording once.
Yes, please stop the recording.